Hello, Ask Gamers. Do you want to see your video game ideas come to life today? In today's video, we are going to show you how you can take your ideas from your notebook and turn them into a fully playable game. We'll walk you through the entire process, step by step, going through planning, art, and finally getting your game into an engine, specifically Construct 3 for this tutorial. We are Ask GameDev, aka the Depeche Mode of clean code, aka the Sultans of Syntax, aka a tribe called EverQuest. And this is how to make a game in Construct 3, Super Teal Robot, Part 1. Welcome back. If you're new to Ask GameDev, we make videos to help you learn about the games industry so that you can elevate your games and inspire others. If you're on a game dev journey, consider subscribing, as our community works together through videos and comments to share insights and best practices that will help your game development. Today, we're starting a series where we're going to build a game starring everyone's favorite Ask GameDev mascot, Super Teal Robot, in Construct 3. First, we'll start small and build upon this project with each new tutorial. Construct 3 is a drag-and-drop game engine, and this tutorial will not require any coding. If you'd like to know more about drag-and-drop engines and how they work, you can check out our recent video, Make Games Without Coding Using These Engines, here. So, where do we even begin? Well, when it comes to starting projects, never forget the ask rule. Always start knowing. Before you lay down any freshly authored game code, know exactly what you're going to make. Know what assets you have to draw, know what rules you have to have in place, know how your characters will interact. If you don't know what you're going to make and just hope it comes to you while you're in the engine, you might end up wasting a lot of time scratching your head. This isn't to say that you're setting your plan in stone. Think of it more as a roadmap. There are a lot of ways to get from point A to point B, you just need to know where B is. So how exactly do you plan? A plan can only come into place when you have a goal. So the first step is to set your objective. Let's use what we're making in this demo as an example. For today's tutorial, we will keep it simple. We're going to try to accomplish three things. 1. Get Super Teal Robot into the game on a platform. 2. Give Super Teal Robot the ability to walk. 3. Give Super Teal Robot the ability to shoot his arm cannon. Now that we have our objectives, we start the next phase of planning. Creating an asset list. Let's do that now. Our first objective is to get Super Teal Robot into the game, on a platform. For that, we'll only need two assets, Super Teal Robot and a platform. Next, we want him to walk. What assets will we need for that? Well, we'll need his walk animation. This means we'll need to draw what Super Teal Robot will look like walking, frame by frame. Finally, we want Super Teal Robot to be able to fire his arm cannon. For this, we'll need a shoot animation, and we'll also need to draw a bullet. So in total, we'll need Super Teal Robot standing, Super Teal Robot walking, Super Teal Robot shooting, and a bullet. So now we have our objectives, we know where we want to end up, and we have our asset list. We know what we need to draw or source. The third and final step of planning is event and rule planning. Once we start plugging in our assets into the game, we need the asset to be able to do things, interact, and come alive. Just like how we made our asset list, let's go through our objectives one at a time and start building our events and rules list. Objective 1. Get Super Teal Robot into the game on a platform. This one is simple, no events, just rules. The platform has to act like a platform, and Super Teal Robot has to act like a physical object. Give Super Teal Robot the ability to walk. For this, we need two events. 1. When the user presses the walk button, we need Super Teal Robot to move. And 2. When Super Teal Robot walks, we need to play his walk animation. Our third objective, give Super Teal Robot the ability to shoot his arm cannon, will also have two events. 1. When the user presses the shoot button, Super Teal Robot will play his shoot animation. And 2. A bullet will have to spawn from Super Teal Robot and move in the direction that Super Teal Robot is facing. And with that, we have the three elements that we need to jump into the engine: our objectives, our asset list, and our events and rules list. So as you can see, a lot of work and planning is put into a game before a single line of game code is written. So never let the lack of coding ability hinder you from planning and creating games. Let's fire up Construct 3. Head over to editor.construct.net. If you don't already have an account, go ahead and create one. Construct 3 has a free version that we can use for this demo. The best part of Construct 3 is that there's nothing to install. All of this happens in your browser. When you're ready, click New Project. Name it whatever you want. We'll call ours Super Teal Robot Tutorial 1. SD Landscape 69. Landscape is fine. Click Create. Welcome to Construct 3 Workspace. If it all looks overwhelming right now, don't worry. We'll explain portions of the interface as we use them. Let's start with Objective 1. Get Super Teal Robot into the game on a platform. For this, we'll need our Super Teal Robot asset and our platform. As you can see, I have a Windows folder open that contains all of the assets from the asset list that we created. Drag each asset one at a time from the folder into the workspace within the dotted line. The area within the dotted line is the section that the player will see when the game is running. Try pressing the play button. This will give you a simulation of the game as it stands. As you can see, nothing happens. It's like looking at a picture. We need to give them rules. Click on Super Teal Robot, then click Behaviors. Super Teal Robot's Behaviors window will pop up. Click Add New Behavior. These are all of the behaviors that are built into Construct 3. Scroll down to the bottom and click Platform. This will make Super Teal Robot behave like a platforming game character. Now press play again. Super Teal Robot will fall right through. We need to give the platform a behavior. Click the platform, then click Behaviors, then Add New Behavior. Check out the description for Solid. Make the object impassable, so other objects cannot move or fall through it. That sounds like exactly what we need. Click that, and then click Add. Now run the game again. We have completed Objective 1. Now on to the next one. Objective 2. Give Super Teal Robot the ability to walk, just like we planned. For this, we'll need the walking animation and two events. 1. When the user presses the walk button, we need Super Teal Robot to move. And 2. When Super Teal Robot walks, we need to play his walk animation. Try running the game again. Press left. He walks, but how? Well, when we gave him the platform behavior, the walk feature was built into that, so we can scratch that one off the list. Next, let's set up his walk animation. For this, we'll go into the Sprite Editor. Double-click on Super Teal Robot. On the right, you'll see the animation section. This is an important area, so get familiar with it. Right-click in the animation area and click Add Animation. Let's name it Walk. At the bottom, you'll see the Frame section. Let's import the walk frames. Right-click, click Import Frames from Files, and Add Your Frames. In Animation Properties section, click Loop, and close the Sprite Editor. Next, we need to tie this walk animation into Super Teal Robot's walk. We are basically telling the engine that when Super Teal Robot walks, play his animation called Walk. For this, we'll need the event sheet. The event sheet is where all the logic and variables are kept. Click on the Event Sheet tab at the top. Click Add Event. Click Super Teal Robot. Scroll down to the platform conditions and click On Moved. So now the engine knows to keep track for when Super Teal Robot is walking and do something. But do what? We have to add that. Click Add Action to the right. Click Super Teal Robot and click Set Animation. Set the animation to walk and click Done. Press Preview. He now plays his walk animation, but he doesn't stop. To fix this, add another event. Click Add Event, then click on Super Teal Robot. For the condition, go with On Stopped. Now let's add an action. This time, let's set Super Teal Robot's animation back to the default. Test it out. We have completed Objective 2. Now, on to the final objective. Give Super Teal Robot the ability to shoot his arm cannon. Let's recap. For assets, we need Super Teal Robot's shoot animation and a bullet. For events, we need two. 1. When the user presses the shoot button, Super Teal Robot will have to play his shoot animation. And 2. A bullet needs to spawn from Super Teal Robot and move in the direction that Super Teal Robot is facing. Let's start with importing the bullet. This time, drag the bullet into the workspace, but outside of the dotted line. Doing this will create the bullet as an object into your game without having to show it on screen. Click on the bullet and add a behavior. Luckily for us, the type of behavior we want is built right into the engine. Click on Bullet and Add. Now let's give the Super Teal Robot his shoot animation. It's the same process that we went through for the walk animation. Let's call this one shoot. So we want the player to be able to press the shoot button, then have Super Teal Robot shoot a bullet while playing a shoot animation. Simple enough, right? But how do we add controls? The walk was already built in, but this is new. For this, we'll have to introduce a new concept, input objects. Right-click in the workspace and click Insert New Object. Scroll down to the Input section and click Keyboard. You now have a keyboard as an object. This means you can use it in events. Let's go to the Events tab. Add an event, click Keyboard, then click On Key Pressed for the condition. Now just enter the key you'd like. We'll use G. Now when the player presses G on their keyboard, we can have whatever we want happen. We are going to add two events. The first event you'll be familiar with. We want to set Super Teal Robot's animation to shoot. You already know how to do that. And for the second event, we want a bullet to appear from Super Teal Robot. Click Add Action, click Super Teal Robot. Then for an action, click Spawn Another Object. Choose the bullet and click Done. Test it out. He now shoots a bullet when you press G. Now let's do two things to polish. We need him to go back to his default state after shooting, and we also need him to spawn the bullet from the correct place. Add an event for Super Teal Robot. Click on Finished, then type in Shoot for the animation. For the action, set his animation back to the default. To move the spawn of the bullet, go back to the sprite editor of Super Teal Robot and right-click on the Image Points area to add an image point. Call it Cannon. Then click where you want the bullet to spawn from. Close the sprite editor. Now go back to the events, open the spawn event, and type in Cannon in the image point field. Voila. Congrats. You've made the start to a fun action platformer. In the next video in this series, we'll take a look at polishing and tweaking these movements and at giving Super Teal Robot some new weapons. It'll involve creating more art, and we'll also talk about variables. If you have any ideas for powers for Super Teal Robot, let us know. Should he have a bubble gun? A flamethrower? We'll pick a few and put them into the game for the next tutorial. Thanks for watching. We are Ask GameDev, and we make videos on game development, the game industry, and more. If you like our channel, the best thing you can do to help is to upvote the video or leave a comment. We publish new content every week on how to elevate your games, so consider subscribing and hit the bell below to be notified as soon as a new video is available.